What is up, my dudes? Welcome back to another vlog. I have a fitness challenge for you today that we are doing 500 push-ups, 500 curls, 500 tricep extensions, 500 lateral raises, and 500 rows, literally hitting every body part today. This one is gonna be intense. I have not done a 500 Fridays. Technically, it's Saturday. 500 Fridays like this in a hot minute. So, I have no idea how this is about to go, but yeah, I love this new camera so much. We're about to get this workout in and then go eat Mexican food because we deserve it after this long workout. Mexican food, always the goat. About to get margaritas, some chicken, some rice. But first, we gotta work. Let's get it, Swoley Moly crew. The first thing that we're doing are some push-ups. We're on set 6 right now of 20. So 20 sets of 25 starts us off on push-ups. And yeah, I'm feeling it already. Right here in my chest. Got this little Swoley Moly Tiger hoodie. But yeah, I'm feeling it already. I can't breathe, I'm waiting for the exhale. Talk my pain with my wishes in a wishing well. Still no luck, but oh well. I still try even though I know I'm gonna fail. Stress on my shoulders like an anvil. Perky got me itching like an anvil. All right, we are in 225 push-ups right now. Chest is like super tight all the way across. My arms aren't really feeling it as much. I usually feel it in my shoulders and rear delts when I do this. But chest is very tight and hurting right now. We did hit 225 on bench for 5 yesterday, so probably not the smartest idea to be doing right now, but who cares? Let's make fitness fun. This is the part where I tell you I'm fine, but I'm lying. I just don't. Okay, 300 push-ups in. This is about the time like when I feel my arms and chest like start going numb because the last 200 are not as bad as the first 300. It's just, I've learned it from over time. I've done this so many times. But yeah, 200 push-ups left. Feeling it, feeling it. How are you feeling, Carr?
Oh, fucking horrible. I can't feel my arms.
That's how I'm feeling too. We just hit the 400 mark on it. So only 100 left. Usually on this one, I didn't tell you, we go 2 sets at 25 and then 1 set at 50 to finish it off.
Okay.
I still try even though I know I'm gonna fail. Stress on my shoulders like an anvil. Perky got me itching like an anthill. Drugs killing me softly, Lord help.
Okay, this is the last set. 50 reps. Let's get it. It's gonna be tough. Okay, so we just finished up 500 push-ups. Now we got 500 lateral raises and 500 rows. Probably go 20 sets of 25 on this. And then when we do the curls, we're gonna go 10 sets of 50 because it's just a little easier to do that and time-wise. We're already 34 minutes in. Okay, I was officially set 5 and I way underestimated the 12s on lateral raises. My arms are already dead and we're only set 5 of 20 in and we got 15 left. Okay, let's get it though.
There are some babes on Peloton, like.
Aren't you like with the class or whatever?
Huh?
Aren't you like with the class?
Yeah.
Can they hear you?
Compete. Dude, you can compete against people. I have never lost. Cause like they'll say, turn your resistance up to 45, and I'll go like 60. And so I'm just going at the same cadence they are, but higher resistance.
Can they tell?
Huh?
Can they tell that you're doing higher resistance?
Well, my score will be like 10 higher than theirs.
Oh.
I'll be like, how'd you get that?
We are going through it right now. We just finished up rows and lateral raises, and now we got 500 curls, and my arms are feeling pumped. Like, God, we just finished up the first set of that. But, dude, this is a tough workout right here. 500 of everything. Okay, we're halfway done with this bad boy now. Yes, sir. Halfway done with this bad boy. And man, my arms are like pumped up, finding new veins in my arms because like it's a juicy one. I cannot wait for Mexican food and margaritas after this. Okay, boys, I know I have not done one of these in a hot minute, but I am back with another recipe. I've just been eating the same things out of my cookbook. You can find it, link in bio on Instagram if you wanna go check it out. But we are doing breakfast tacos this morning with an updated recipe. So first, you are gonna need these beef fajita things. They come in a little pack, it's like $3. Next, you are gonna need Mexican Velveeta shreds. This cheese is like super low in calories and probably the best for melting on anything since it is Velveeta. Next, you are gonna need your egg whites that look yellow. They look yellow, so it tricks your brain into thinking, oh, I'm actually eating eggs and they taste good. Sorry, I have like, I personally just do not like eggs any way they taste. Like I cannot eat them without another meat being in the eggs. Yeah, so that's why I have to trick my brain. Egg whites are just disgusting in my opinion. And the final thing, you are gonna need your carb counter tortillas. You can also use flat wraps, but I'm allergic to flat wraps, surprise, surprise. So, let's get these breakfast tacos cooking because I am starving. It is like 7:32 right now. And why is this steaming? What? My camera stopped recording there for a second, so I'm gonna show you guys what I did. I opened up the fajita package and literally just put all the fajita meat in here because it's not that much fajita meat. And then I put the tortillas on a pretty low setting just so they can warm up and brown up a little bit so they'll be ready at the same time these are. The steak's already cooked, but you still wanna get it like hot and a little bit brown. Chop it up if you can because that will just make it easier in the end. But we're gonna let this brown up for a minute. Okay, so now your fajita meat is all nice and browned up. Open up your egg whites and just kinda eyeball how much you want in there, how many tacos you wanna make. That should be good. That's probably about 4 servings of egg whites right there. Pretty good at eyeballing this now. Yeah, that's probably about 4 servings of egg whites.
I turned up these a little bit so they brown up a little faster, because they're, this, electric grills are so much worse than gas grills. I'll tell you what, I need my gas grill back. Okay guys, the thing is now all browned up, and I was giving the tortillas way too much credit. They are taking a lot longer to brown up, so we're just not gonna have like very crunchy tortillas for this, but that is okay, because we are still going to be able to make tacos. Okay, so now you got your two tortillas off the grill, grab all your steak and taco meat. Wait, don't grab that yet. Don't grab that yet. Let it cook. First thing you are gonna do after you have your tortillas on a plate is put down a layer of cheese so it melts like a lot better, because it will melt way better at the bottom because everything is a lot hotter when it first sits on it. So arrange your tortillas, if it wants to work with me today. Arrange your tortillas, put the cheese at the bottom just so it melts, and then we're going to grab our steak and eggs, fajita steak and eggs, and you are just gonna dump a little bit on it, maybe a lot bit on it. There's gonna be some beefy tacos, some big old tacos. Move. Oh yeah. And the last thing that I like to do is add a little bit of salsa on the top. This is Clint's Texas salsa. It's like a medium hot. Actually, I might just put this in a bowl and then eat it from that. This is the beautiful, beautiful recipe for these new steak and egg breakfast tacos. Oh my gosh. Let's get the first bite even without salsa. So unbelievably good, boys. This is a must try. Time to go devour this and finish up the vlog. This is where we're ending the vlog today. Hope you enjoyed all these workouts. If you haven't already, go pick you up some of the best pre-workout out there. Hardcore Reckoning. This stuff literally amazing. 400 milligrams of caffeine. It will wake you up. And paired with that, you got some sweat ethic bassoed. I've been preaching this for so long. Better endurance and better breathing for all of your workouts. Go check it out. Code OakFit for the sweat ethic one, and then code SWOLEMOLE for this. Support your boy. I love you guys. If you haven't already, cop the merch. I'll see you later.